Why did you choose to accept your award in this country, and why didn't you fly over to the States to join all the other stars?
Horrible, isn't it? And I hate award ceremonies, and unashamedly, you know, I thought it would be good to do to get take this lifetime thing, you know, because I thought it was a good plug for the record. I hate awards. I think they're also phony and backslapping. But I thought it's a sort of compromise. You know, we do it by satellite. We don't have to fly to Los Angeles and sit there with all those other idiots.
And the other thing that you did earlier this week was a memorial gig for Ian Stewart.
Yeah.
And you kept that very private, didn't you?
Yeah, it was like, yeah, it wasn't a sort of Fleet Street bonanza, no. But we had a great time. It was a good laugh. And we did numbers that Stu would have liked and so on. And we had a sort of fun lineup. I mean, at one point, it was extremely difficult to cut through these guitar players. You had Keith and Ronnie and Eric Clapton, Pete Townsend and Jeff Beck. All sort of, it was like a wailing wall of guitars. But it was a really fun occasion.
Of course, you're no stranger to the 100 Club, are you?
No, we've been going there for years. It's a nice little club.
Well, you said it was a plug for the record. We'll play the A side of the single now, Harlem Shuffle. Your new single then from the Rolling Stones, and that's Harlem Shuffle from the album Dirty Work. Why did you release that as a single? I mean, the Stones were doing cover versions over 20 years ago. Yeah. Why come back with a cover version?
Well, there you go. It's, Steve Lillywhite said, well, yeah, you started out as a cover band, so here you go again. So, yeah, it's the one cover version on the album, and it seemed to be what everyone seemed to like instantly. You know, the thing about singles is, I think you sometimes have to go for the obvious, rather than trying to be too searching about.
But that's going to be obvious anyway, isn't it? Because it's familiar.
Yeah, well, I don't know. It's not familiar around the world. It was a hit here, but it wasn't a hit anywhere else. It's not, I mean, you play it to people, they've never ever heard of it before, only in England.
So, I mean, was it, you know, everybody, a unanimous decision, that's the one that we go for?
Yeah, more or less.
Where was the album recorded?
In Paris, last year. Yeah.
And why did you choose Steve Lillywhite as your producer?
He's such a good-looking young boy, dear. No, I mean, he was seen to be, like, into, you know, recording bands as bands rather than a producer that you would use for a solo artist, you know, choose musicians and such. He seemed to be, you know, his work with bands was good and without sort of dominating or being domineering. He, you know, keep the sound of the band and put his own ideas and get his own sound together.
He always seems to capture what a band would sound like live, Steve Lillywhite.
Kind of, yeah, you know, it's like, there's a lot of work that you don't see, but I mean, that's the whole thing of it.
And on the single, Bobby Womack, and which bits does he do?
He goes, do the monkey shine. Yeah, you can hear him, he's in there.
What made you ask for him?
Well, we know him for ages, Bobby Womack, and he just came to Paris for a week or so. And then he was in New York for the mixing, I think. Yeah, he was in New York for this when he did this bit. Yeah, it was nice to have around, you know. It's good to have someone to sing with, you know, from time to time. It really pushes you.
There are, of course, a variety of people on the album. There's Jimmy Page as well, isn't there? And there's Jimmy Cliff and Kirsty MacColl.
Yeah, we had, like, a lot of people sort of dropping by, and some of them we kept and some we don't. But I think it's a pretty open album, insofar as that's concerned.
Well, I know later in the month we're going to have a chance to actually hear the album in depth. What are your plans while you're in this country at the moment? What do you hope to get up to?
Behave myself as much as I can slightly. Yeah, you know, I've been getting out, seeing a lot of old friends, you know, and getting out, going to movies and going to clubs and dancing about. I'm only here for like a few days, actually. But so far I've had a really good time.
Well, I shall see you towards the end of the month, as I say.
Right.
This is the B-side of the single, Had It With You. Mm-hmm. Yeah, 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 the knees are like jelly. That's the B-side of the Rolling Stones single, Harlem Shuffle. That track is Had It With You. And both of those tracks are featured on the new Rolling Stones album, which is called Dirty Work. It was just a brief chat with Mick tonight, who brought the single in. But I realised before I said at the end of the month, I mean next month, Mick will be coming in again and we'll be having a long, long chat. And playing tracks from the album and other bits and pieces as well. Mick Jagger, thank you very much indeed.